Well, good morning, Madam. Today we can discuss about a very important file that is called as a plaque helmet. This here, what is meant with plaque? Plaque indicates flat. Helmet this indicates arms. Flat arms indicates. Now this one is the dorsal side and this one is the ventral side. Dorso ventrally compressed manner that is called as a plaque part. That's why the plaque helmet is indicates the flat. Now we can go for the habitat where the organism is living. This plaque helminthes are mostly parasitical nature. What is parasitical nature? The organism is dependent upon the another organism for food and shelter. That is called as a parasitical nature. And some organisms are the free living nature. That's why in plaque helminthes some it can show the parasitical nature, some it can show the free living nature. Now if we go for the locomotion, here the locomotion is what type of movement? The hydrostatic movement. What is meant by hydrostatic movement? Now this one is the organism. Inside they have a body fluid. This body fluid is pushed back and organism is moved forward. By the using of this fluid, the organism can move forward. That type of movement is called as a hydrostatic movement. And then, if we go for the symmetry, I already said here the symmetry is what type of symmetry? Bilateral symmetry. First two three phyla, that is the porifera, nidaria, and pterophora. The symmetry is the radial symmetry. The first two type bilateral symmetry can be seen in the plaque helminthes. I already said what is bilateral symmetry. Now this one is the body. Through median sagittal plane, if you cut the body can be divided into two equal parts. That type of symmetry is called as a bilateral symmetry. That's why the first time bilateral symmetry can be seen in the plaque helminthes. And then layers. How many layers is there? Three layers is there. That condition is called as a triploblastic nature. That is ectodermal, mesodermal, and endodermal. Three germ layers is present. That nature is called as a triploblastic nature. That's why keep in mind the first type triploblastic nature and the bilateral symmetry condition can be seen in the plaque helminthes. Now, if we go for the level of organization, I already said in animal kingdom mainly four levels is present. One is the cellular level, another one is the tissue level, another one is the organ level, another one is the organ system level. Now, cellular level can be seen in where? Porifera, tissue level. That is in the nidaria and pterophora. Organ level. Keep in mind, here they can show both organ level and organ system level. But mostly we can consider here the level of organization is the organ level of organization. And then, if we go for the cenome. See, the cenomes is three types. One is the acenome. Another one is the pseudocenome, another one is the trucenome. Yet what type we will discuss about the cenomes. At the time of triploblastical nature, at the time only we can discuss about the cenome. This is the first triploblastical nature. Now the cenome is what type of cenome? Acenome. Acenome is there is no body cavity. That's why here the cenome is what type of cenome? Acenome. After cenome, acenome, next is what? Pseudocenome. After plaque helminthes, next one is a Asca helminthes are also called as a nematoda. In that phylum, we can see the pseudocenome. After pseudocenome, next is what? Trucenome. After nematoda, also after nematoda, the next phylum is the Annelida. In Annelida, we can choose what type of cenome? Trucenome. Now, here the cenome is the acenome. Here there is no body cavity. Now, if we go for the circulatory system. Here the circulatory system is what type of circulatory system? Open circulatory system. Here open circulatory system is there is no blood vessels. That's why the blood is bathed in the body cavity. That type of circulatory system is called as a open circulatory system. And then nerve system. The nerve system is a gangliated one. What is meant by ganglia? This one is the nerve cell. All the nerve cells can be concentrated at one point. That is called as a ganglia. That type of cells is called as a ganglia cells. And then the respiration. If the organism is a parasite, the respiration is the anaerobical respiration. Without the oxygen, the respiration is takes place, that is called as an anaerobical respiration. If the organisms are free living, the respiration is the cutaneous respiration. What is meant by cutaneous respiration? Through skin, the respiration is takes place. That type of respiration is called as a cutaneous respiration. And then reproduction is what type of reproduction? Mostly they are the sexual reproduction. Here they can release their gametes. And then excretor system. Here very important one. The excretor cells is the flame cells. Why they name as a flame cells means the flame blowing like this. The same thing when it is collect the nitrogenous waste material, it is flipped like a flame. That's why it is called as a flame cells. Flame cells is also called as a protonephridia. And then the exoskeleton, extra features and classes, we can discuss under the classes. Okay, now classes. How many classes is present? They have been three classes. One is the terminalia, another one is the prematoda, another one is the cestoda. First one is the terminalia, the second one is the prematoda, and the third one is the cestoda. Now, in terminalia, the organisms are the free living nature. Now, free living nature is compulsory. The respiration is what type of respiration? Cutaneous respiration. Now, this one is an organism. This organism thought by a mucous membrane. That the mucous membrane is called as a rabdite. And the very important one, it can show the power of regeneration capacity. If the cut the organism from this phase, the remaining after few days, remaining this part is formed. That is called as a power of regeneration capacity. Here the larva name is the Müller's larva. The best example is the Dagesia. Dagesia is also called as a planaria. That's why planaria is what habitat? Free living habitat. It can show a specialized character. That character is called as a power of regeneration capacity. Now, the second one, we can go for the trematoda. Trematoda and cestoda both are the parasitical nature. Here the exoskeleton is called as a tegument. It is made up of a calcium. Here the exoskeleton, they name it as what? Rabdite. Now here this one is called as a tegument. And it can show a polyembryonic condition. Many larva conditions take place. That is called as a polyembryonic condition. The best example is the fasciola. Fasciola is commonly called as a liver fluke. And then the last class, that is called as a cestoda. Cestoda is also called as a parasitical agent. Here the exoskeleton is called as a syncytial tegument. That's why we can say three exoskeletons. One is a rabdite, another one is the tegument, another one is the syncytial tegument. Now, if the organism is parasite, compulsory they having a hooks and suckers are present. Now, this one is an organism, they having a hooks and suckers. Hooks can hold the host and suckers, it can suck the food material. And then, here they have a larva that is called as a cysticercus larva. And the best example is the tinea solium. Tinea solium is commonly called as a tapeworm. Nulubulu. Now, here very important character according to the cestoda. It can show pseudo-metabolism. What is meant by pseudo-metabolism? On body, they have a segment. This line is called as a segment. If the segment is present both externally and internally, that is called as a true metabolism. But I wrote here pseudo metabolism. Pseudo metabolism means the segments, either it is present externally or it is present internally, that is called as a pseudo metabolism. For this cestoda, the segments is present in the outside. Now, that metabolism is called as a pseudo metabolism. Cestoda is the specialized characters they have in a pseudo metabolism. Tomorrow we can discuss about nematoda.